I was very keen to be involved in a sequel because I was in the middle of doing the Pirates trilogy, and I was thinking, well, you know, there's something slightly expected or predictable if a summer commercially driven film does well, then they make more, you know. And I was very intrigued by the prospect of doing a film that I'd done many years before from a completely different, you know, dramatic historical genre, of what it would be like to work with the same team but all be older and have done many different things since the first film, and it for it not to be specifically driven with on commercial principles. Reminded me a bit of The Godfather, you know. There haven't been that many films I can think of off the top of my head where they've expanded on the story. Or maybe the Bob Hope, Bing Crosby road movies. Second time around, I think the key difference is that in the first film, he had a fairly specific dramatic function, which was to mentor this young, uncertain woman to become God's representative on earth, on the throne, and take on the responsibilities of being the queen in a very tumultuous age, and for her youth to bring her to some kind of, you know, political and philosophical maturity, which by the end of the film is sort of being achieved. That was the curtain moment of that film. But in the second film, this one, Shaker was very interested in looking at what happens to not only a long-term political relationship, you know, a bit like we've become a bit like a middle-aged married couple who spend a long, perhaps far too long together. We were interested in the idea of what happens when somebody who's so self-assured about their almost fanatical beliefs in the state, of what happens when that kind of blows up in his face. My son was there at the time, who was 11, and he was intrigued by the achievement of, you know, I suppose the speculation, you know, if telling the stories is, for an actor, is imaginative play, and hopefully through that you inspire the imaginations of the audience. When you actually see the process of, for example, the father of the one guy that I've squashed into that spiky cage, and they bring the dad out who's been flayed. I watch them do a lot of that makeup, and you kind of get really intrigued by the medical accuracy or the anatomical accuracy, but also a bit thrilled by the craft of it. So I, by the end of it, I'm not looking at him as being gruesome. No, I wasn't around when they shot all that, so I had no, I actually, to be honest, had no idea how, ultimately, when I saw the film, how huge and spectacular and impressive, and how big a character the fight between Spain and England is within the film. There's some extraordinary filmmaking and you know, brilliant imagery and metaphors at work there. No. Well, I mean, no, this was for me, you know, there's 140 years between Raleigh and Barbossa. Never thought I'd mention them in the same sentence. So that all always felt very different,